Hello everyone. In this session, we will be discussing about adaptations to diving. Marine organisms or marine mammals free dive better than us because of few modification, physiological modifications and adaptations are developed in that specific organisms. Coming to the details, they have adapted for the free diving, and in the evolutionary process few physiological modifications are taken. Those are, with compared to the normal terrestrial organisms, marine mammals or marine organisms or free diving organisms have developed more energetic resources in their body, in their system, and better adaptation to pressure. They have adapted to pressure, and better dive response and better breath hold control and more efficient recovery. Coming to the more energetic resources, for the free diving they have acquired with the well developed oxygen storing organs in the aerobic system, more oxygen in the muscle they have evolved, and they are stored oxygen in the muscle and in the blood, in the brain. Coming to the blood, higher blood volumes with compared to the terrestrial organisms. Then retia mirabilia is one of the tissue which store more oxygen than others, and splenic oxygen stores. Spleen is an organ. This organ store oxygen in the marine animals, and it is more than bigger than the terrestrial organisms, and it helps to store oxygen in the body. And otric bulb, this is a structure, otra increase at the immediate exit from the heart by 30 to 40%, and ramifications for all gates vessels. As consequence, the bulb has a capacity of storage of the stroke work of the more than two normal heartbeats and a volume of more than three times normal stroke volume. It resists for the stroke and helps to the organism to free dive. Coming to the more red blood cell contents, seal blood consists of 60% of hemoglobin versus 35 to 40% of whereas it has 35 to 40% in humans. Seal blood consists 60% of hemoglobin. It is 35 to 40 in humans. So the difference is very great with compared to the human beings. In shallow diving mammals, including humans, hemoglobin content is 14 to 16 gram per 100 ml blood. Whereas deep diving mammals, it is 21 to 25 gram hemoglobin per 100 ml blood. So more hemoglobin, more oxygen diffusion capacity. So it is one of the great adaptation for the diving organisms. Next, more oxygen stored in the brain, higher concentration of globin proteins. Certain marine mammals are protected by elevated levels of complex oxygen carrying proteins called globins in the cerebral cortex. These species have evolved the capacity to protect their brain from conditions of low oxygen. When the low oxygen arise in the system, These proteins protect the organism from the damage, from the consequences of hypoxia. So this is one of the adaptation. Then the anaerobic system. The anaerobic system, this is one of the physiological modification under more energetic resources. More glycogen stored in the muscle. More glycogen stored in the muscle. According to the previous studies, marine mammals having more glycogen contents than the terrestrial organisms, and it helps for the better diving capacity. And delayed effect of the lactic acid. The lactic acid is blocked by the vasoconstriction, and its effects are delayed until the animal arrives at the surface. Lactic acid is blocked because of lactic acid production may lead to the muscle consequences, muscle pain. So the production of lactic acid is blocked by the vasoconstriction, and its effect are delayed until the animal arrives at the surface. This is one of the adaptation for the better diving. Next, coming to the second adaptation, better adaptation to pressure. Pressure is the major component in the major challenge for the diving in the deep sea or deep diving animals. Allocation of oxygen store away from the lungs. Oxygen stores away from the lungs. Many relay mainly on lungs. Man relay mainly on lungs to store oxygen. But for the marine mammals, the percentage of oxygen contained in the lungs is minimal. The blood and the muscle being the main carriers in their case. Only 5% of oxygen store are kept in the lungs in the case of the faucet seals, whereas 51% in humans. Lung oxygen, lung stores minimum oxygen, whereas more oxygen store away from the lung. This is the better adaptation for the pressure. And next one is flexible chest walls. The chest of marine mammals can squeeze to let the lungs virtually airless. Human free divers can improve the chest flexibility, but not at the extent. Next one is cartilaginous rings reinforcing the airways. Shallow diving mammals have partially calcified ring on the airways, maintaining them open deeper than the human airways could support, but prohibiting diving to the extreme depths reached by the species presenting collapsible airways system. Deep diving mammals have low calcification. Note this point. Deep diving mammals having low calcification of trachea rings, which can bend without breaking at extreme depth also. Pressure resistance because of the low calcification of tracheal rings. So next one is sphincter muscles in the smaller airways. Marine mammals have very muscular bronchioles able to close the air passage. This allows progressive collapse of lung structure at present with initial collapse of the alveoli, followed by small and then large airways. This pattern works in reverse during ascent, and the lungs are able to reinflate in a progressive manner. The lungs collapse is blocking the gas exchange, minimizing the risk of related oxygen to excessive nitrogen build up. So this is one of the adaptation. Next, control of body floatability. Control of body floatability. The dugong uses the sphincter muscles of the bronchioles to compress the density of the air lungs and changes the floatability without expelling air or using flippers. The flippers are the organs for using for the swimming. Since cartilages occurs throughout the length of the air passages, this keeps the air volume compressed when needed. For the resistance of the pressure, for the better adaptation is oxygen repartition, flexible chest walls, cartilages and rings, sphincter muscles, variable body density. So next one is better dive response, bradycardia. Heart rate of marine mammals can go below 5% of period, whereas 70% of humans. Next, metabolic inhibition with reduction in temperature. Marine mammals adjust swimming speeds and metabolic rates to sustain all dives aerobically. So this is one of the adaptation. Selective ischemia also. During the dive, the marine animals or mammals present selective ischemia, which is similar with the peripheral vasoconstriction encountered in humans. One adaptation. Next, fourth one is better breath hold control. For humans, the breath hold control is closely related to the inspiratory reflex manifested as diaphragmatic constriction, which seems to be missing in the case of marine mammals. No diaphragmatic constriction is occurred in the marine mammals. So this is one of the better adaptation. Next one is more efficient recovery. Even for long sessions of long and deep dives, marine mammals only needs to breathe for a few minutes on the surface and they are completely recovered. The below table shows surface. It is not needed for you. Okay. Diving behavior, empty lungs, full lungs, exhale and descent, exhale and ascent, warm up. These are the some other characteristics. Comparing with the cardiovascular and respiratory system of marine mammals and human, we could see a series of physiological advantages explaining the biggest depth and dive time marine mammals are able to reach by these five major adaptations. Thank you very much.